Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I wanted to walk through how to do cross-cell reporting in Analysis Workspace. The cross-cell report in Reports and Analytics displays the relationship between products in the same product string so that you can analyze what products are purchased together. Our customers often ask us if the cross-cell report is available in Analysis Workspace, so we wanted to put together this video to show you how to do that type of analysis. We're going to focus on the product use case. We want to understand what products are being purchased together so that we can cross-promote related items to other visitors who are shopping. Let's start by building a product table. Bringing in product as rows, but also as a cross-tab column, won't give you the desired report that you're looking for. Our breakdowns work at the most granular level, which in the case of multi-value dimensions means sub-hit. It will not show the other dimensions that were passed in on the string. As a result, you just get data down the diagonal, like you see here in this table. So we're going to undo that action, and instead of bringing the product in as a column, we're going to open it up and bring it in as a dropdown instead. Multi-selecting, dragging over to the drop zone and holding shift, we can create a dropdown of different products. The drop zone at the top creates hit level segments by default, which is exactly what we need to show other values on the product string. You can sneak any one of these segments that was created to better understand the container that is used. So here we can see hit where product equals Timberline GTX boots. So toggling to different products, you'll notice the table underneath updates. The top product is the one that you selected, which makes sense. And then rows 2 onward are the other products purchased at the same time. Adding in metrics like revenue and revenue per order, you can sort descending to see which high ticket items are often cross-sold and make some promotion decisions based on that information. So looking product by product may get tedious, so we wanted to give you a way to step up the report to a higher level. Instead of using product, you can use a classification of product, such as product type. Dragging product type over into the table and also creating a dropdown of product type, you'll be able to do this cross-cell analysis at the product type level. We'll just go ahead and quickly delete our product dropdown. And now instead of looking product by product, we can look at our different product groups. So we can see if we filter to jackets, what other product types were commonly purchased with jackets. We'll go ahead and sort on orders. So we see jackets at the top. And then we can see that boots, hats, gloves, and shirts are most often cross-sold along with jackets. Cross-sell reporting in Analysis Workspace is much more flexible than what Reports and Analytics offers today. You can not only look at product dimensions like we've done here, but you can bring in any multi-value dimension or classification that you'd like as well. Another application of this could be to analyze an internal promotion list var that is capturing promotion impressions. This analysis would help you see which promotions are shown at the same time on a page, from which you could make some decisions on what combinations of promotions are most effective. This has been a walkthrough of cross-cell reporting in Analysis Workspace. We hope it's stirred up some ideas on how you can apply this type of analysis to your business.